Alright folks, what's up? How's things? How are you? It's been ages since I made a video, but I'm in the mood for making a video at the moment. I'll throw a quick DVD update at you here. It isn't all the stuff that I've picked up since my last update. I just picked a select few titles that were close to me and I said I'll show them to you now. I'm gonna start off with the horror here as always. I don't have too many horror titles, but I have a few here I'm gonna throw at you. Always, I'm gonna try to do this quickly. I'm gonna try not to do it badly, but I'm making no promises. Anyway, I'm gonna start off here with the horror 3-pack. I picked this up in a charity shop. It only cost me €1, so I said, "Fucking hell yeah, why not? I have to pick it up, even if the movies are shit. It doesn't really matter." So, the first one there is the Bone Snatcher. Next one, Someone's Watching Me. That's old Lois Lane, I think, in it. And the other one's called The Terror, I think that's also known as Nine Lives, has Paris Hilton in it. I don't know, I have it up on the shelf there, I've never watched it, it's a cheap, but I was saying this, and I just had to pick it up, like, a cheap old horror box set, like, basically only really got it for the Bone Snatcher, and someone is watching, I don't even know if it's any good or not, but I said, fuck it, why not, I'll pick that shit up. So there you have it. Another one that I picked up in the charity shop here, it's the Children of the Corn, 1-3 box set. This cost me €2, and I already have this one from back in the day. It's the old Cinema Club one. I have this from well back in the day, but when I seen this, I said I just have to pick it up because I thought the box looked pretty cool, and they're all in their individual boxes. They aren't in that one. I thought the artwork on the boxes and stuff looked pretty cool on this. And when I seen that, I had to pick the thing up. Show you the other ones here, real quick. Yeah man, I thought this was pretty cool for €2 in the charity shop, but I couldn't let it fucking go. Even though I fucking already had the movies and a prick like that, I just had to get them. Now there it is, the Children of Corn 1-3 box set. Happy days. Right, the next one I'm gonna go on to here is Tremors 5. I have the Tremors box set there with the first other four movies, and that's it. I only really enjoyed the first movie. Part 2 was okay-ish. I enjoyed part 3 more than that, and I didn't really enjoy part 4 that much, so, but at least this one's back to being 15s again, so maybe it'll be a little bit more violent and less comedy-ish, but I fucking doubt it, like, but I seen it there, I had to pick it up. Hopefully it's decent. I heard Kevin Bacon wants to make a new TV series of it, and hopefully that happens, because he'll be in it and he wants to bring back Fred Ward for it as well. So if that happens, hopefully they'll make something good out of that, folks. So there it is, Tremors 5. Right. Terminator, the Sarah Connor Chronicles here. Yeah, I've seen this on CEX, so it was like £3. I wasn't the hugest fan of the fucking series, but I enjoyed it somewhat better than some of the sequels. I thought it was better than fucking Terminator 3 and anyway, probably Salvation as well, yeah. And the first season of this was decent. It's a pretty short first season. I thought it was much better than the second season. I thought it went downhill a bit in the second season, but this season, for what it was alright, and for a few quid and sex, you can't go wrong there. Terminator, the Sarah Connor Chronicles. Right, it follows here. I picked this up in Golden List. It was in the 2 for €12 section, I think. I seen this in the cinema when it came out last year, and still not really sure if I liked the thing. I haven't watched it since I picked it up again, but after I seen it in the cinema, I was if and omen, and still if and omen whether or not I actually liked the fucking film. I know it has its fans as well, but I just don't know if I like it, but I'm gonna watch it again. And there's so many final thoughts on it, because I kinda liked it and I kinda didn't like it, but anyway, I'm showing out me here, folks. It follows. There's no you thought of it. Right. Hannibal Rising here. Never seen it. I've only seen the first few with Anthony Hopkins in it. There's no if that's any good. What do you thought of it? Right. Exorcist here. The complete anthology. Yeah, I'll be honest. I've only ever seen the first movie. Picked this up. It was a few quid and sex. So I said I'll get it. And I'm not really in any rush to watch any of your movies. I never have been, but I was there, so I said, fuck it, I'll get it. So there it is, Exorcist Complete Anthology. Well, I just picked up another edition here of Halloween and Five there. It was 50 cents or something in six, so I said I'd get it. It's just another fucking bare bones beauty, I think, but I just got it because it has different artwork than the other Halloween Fives I have. Never been a huge fan of the movie, but if I see a Halloween movie for cheap and I don't even have it, even if it's just different artwork, I'll pick it up. So there you have a Halloween Five. We're going to Maggie here, starring Ernie. This is the other movie that I picked up in the 2 for $12 in a Golden List for It Follows. Yeah, I thought it was okay for what it was. Like, it wasn't brilliant, it wasn't bad, it was just there, like, it was decent enough, like. Yeah, I'd say it's worth watching, but wouldn't run out and fucking get the thing. So there you have it, Maggie. We're going to Annabelle here. It was one of the most disappointing movies, in my opinion, when I went to see it in the cinema. Haven't watched it since then. I only picked it up a couple of weeks ago. It was €1 in a charity shop. It was there, so I said, yeah, why not? I'll get it. Heard they're making a sequel of this. Hope it's better than this fucking original anyway, because this is fucking well disappointing. Seeing as I came from like a Conjuring, I thought the Conjuring was a fucking great film. There it is, Annabelle. And anyway, folks, going to the Cube box set here for DVD special edition. I've always been a big fan of the original Cube movie ever since I first seen on Sky Movies well back in the day when it first premiered. I always thought it was a great fucking pretty underrated film. Don't think you, as far as I remember, the other two couple of sequels aren't that fucking good, but I seen it in sex, it was cheap, and there's a bonus disc as well, so I said fucking why not, I'll pick it up. Cube box set. Just an old Ghostbusters cartoon that brought me back to my youth, I've seen it there. So I said I'll pick it up. Ghostbusters. That was £2 in deals, I think. Right, on to the last one here, folks. Yeah, I'm a sucker for these old cheap old action box sets. I love them, I do. I have a few of them here I'm going to show you. First one here, Expect No Mercy with Billy Blanks. I love the old Blanks. I already had that movie, but I got it for the Expert there with Jeff Speakman. But when I got it home, I realized I already had the fucking Expert as well, but I forgot I had it, but it doesn't really matter. A 25-cent, now you can have another addition to the Blanks there in case we hit. Whether Billy Blanks Expects No Mercy breaks or another Expert breaks. So there you have it. Another cheap old fucking 4-pack box set I got here. I only really got it for the Patrick Swayze collection there, the old Tiger Warsaw. As far as I remember, Split Decisions is okay. Never heard of Whistleblower or Darrow, but just got it for the Swayze. Swayze always gets a boy in my opinion. Another cheap old action box set. Cruel Deep, Jet, Last Line of Defense, and The Storm. I really only got it for The Last Line of Defense. I got to the Oliver Grunier collection. I need to get more of his movies, and El Brad Dourif's in it as well. Like, but I only really got it for The Last Line of Defense there. Another one of them here has Shivers, Final Scream, Cyborg 3, and The Peacekeeper. I only really got it for the Dolph Lundgren there, for the Dolph Lundgren collection, because I already have Shivers. I'd say Final Scream, shit. And I have Cyborg 3, and I know that shit, but look at that, 10 cents, man, you can't go wrong. I'll start wrapping this up pretty quick, folks. Oil in that tree there. Judgment Night here, I really love this movie. I love this ever since back in the day. I seen it when I was fucking a kid. I still haven't finished just downstairs. Very underrated movie from 1993. Cuba Gooding Jr., Emilio Estevez, Stephen Dorff, Dennis Leary. Great cast, really good, underrated action thriller here. Jeremy Piven's in it as well. Haven't seen that, I'd well recommend it. Only cost me €1 and six, so I said why not. I'll go to Forever here. Man, this is my favourite show of the last few years. I think it was the 14th, 15th season. This debuted on ABC, and it only lasted one season, 22 episodes. But so disappointed. I cancelled, man, because it was a fucking great show. It was, like, and since they cancelled it, did ABC his best numbers on a Tuesday night for a long time. And since they cancelled it, two shows have tried to take its place in the dreaded Tuesday 10 o'clock time slot for ABC. One lasted 2 episodes and one lasted 3 episodes. So they should have well kept fucking Forever Around, because it's a great fucking show. Joan Griffith wrapped it. So there you have it, Forever. And all holds barred here. I had to get this, man. It's a cheesy, corny fucking movie, big time. Like, but it was on HMV, brand new, €2. Like, I couldn't pass it up. I think I might still have it on VHS down the stairs. I'm not entirely sure, but I couldn't pass it up. Like, just the cover, man's deadly. Even if it's a bad, cheesy film, like, it doesn't matter. No holds barred. Like, Hard to Kill here. Probably my favourite cigar movie, I'd say. Either that or fucking Out for Justice. That's one of my favourite cigars. And his movies actually used to be good, and they weren't direct to video shite. Full Metal Jacket here. I'm gonna wrap this up now, folks. New World Order, The Revolution. Yeah, I picked this up in sex, it was pretty cheap. I loved the NWO back in the day. I was disappointed with the documentary on this. I thought they could have done so much better. Bloodsport here. My favourite Van Damme movie ever since I was a kid. Technically it's probably not his best movie, but I grew up watching that stuff, so still my favourite to this day. So Bloodsport. And the last one I'm going to show you here is Blue Bloods Season 1 to 5 Collection. I've always said I'm a big Tom Selleck fan. Ever since the Magnum PI days, I've loved Tom Selleck and his shows and his movies and stuff like this. I've only actually ever seen the first season of this. I lost track with it back in the day, like, but Season 6 is almost finished. So I'm picked up for the Season 7, so with this season 6 ends, I'm going to lash into this, get Season 6, lash into that, and hopefully be up to date by the time Season 7 starts. Anyway, folks, that was just my quick DVD update. Talk to you.